So good, it's okay.
Paul Emick of the Weather Channel. It is time to look at the active weather across the western U.S. Tonight, a few showers, you bet. Little trough here causing a few showers to pop up still. A little cool air settling in. Number of things have actually happened in the last a few days. We've seen, of course, the cold front come ashore. Additionally, there's an area of low pressure. You see its depiction there. Also, a little circulation, upper-level system, room across parts of Nevada tonight, moving on, still drawing in moisture. So we still have moisture to work with this system. We're not through with this one yet by a long shot. I mean, it's got several days of extended life. We'll look at that coming up as well. Showers, though, behind the front. That's a cold front, leading edge of a cooler air mass. Cool air is settled in back behind it, put the squeeze to some of the moisture that's still in here. There's a trough, so we have another little extra kicker to help kick the action off tonight. You see kind of a speckled nature, kind of a speckled appearance to some of the clouds here. That's one of the indications we have a lot of cold air kicking in. That's why we've got over 30 inches of snow in Mount Baldy into southern sections of California. Snow problems or snow potential, you bet, throughout California tonight. Things will be drier for San Francisco. We'll look at that in the forecast coming up as well. Showers over L.A. right now. We're dealing with it. San Diego, too. Out around Imperial Beach, Miramar. A few showers even toward National City will move some in here. Heading out for the night, you might need an umbrella. How about for the morning paper? Well, we'll look at that too in the forecast coming up. LA kind of wet tonight around Century City, around Riverside and Torrance, a few showers too. San Francisco, an occasional passing bit of moisture. Around Sausalito, we've seen some wet weather. Also popping up a little bit of times around Berkeley, a little wet weather. Close up vantage point shows where some of the showers are in the Bay Area now. Kind of a wet night here. How do we fare with the temps? 55 was it. That was the best we could do for San Francisco for a high temperature today. 57 around Riverside in Los Angeles. Now, we didn't see a lot of heat because we had the clouds and we had the rain. So we didn't get a chance to get the sunshine there to kick it up. 59 to San Diego, 68 to Phoenix. Pretty mild for high temps, I would say. But that's not bad. 67 for Denver. Kind of like the appearance of that. We're cooling off tonight in the Mile High City. 44 around San Francisco, 49. Reno, Nevada, they're doing a little gaming tonight. There you are, 33, close to freezing. 51 to Phoenix around Tempe tonight, too. Breaking it down a bit, Yakima at 40. Around Redmond, 30. A little further south, Stockton at 43. Marysville at 46. Southern Cal, Ontario at 48. 47 for Palm Springs. As far as the quakes go, Southern California at Lake Elsinore, a couple of a 2.2 magnitude, a 2.1 for Yucca Valley, a 2.0, 26 miles west-southwest of El Centro, and a 2.4, very close, just east-southeast of Big Bear Lake. In the northern parts of California, Nevada, 3 at Alder Springs, 2.2 at the Geysers, a 2.5 just north-northeast of Bernie, a 3.1 near the Geysers, and a couple of 3.1s there, and a 3.5 that was close to Bernie. 6, actually, around this area right now, around I-15. Or just rather east of I-5, I'm trying to say. Washington, Oregon, nothing reported here. In Alaska, nothing available for a report here. I want to mention pretty close to Hoback Junction, Wyoming, a 2.3 magnitude was felt there. Here's the forecast. This thing is moving on. As this thing cranks along, low pressure moving in a counterclockwise motion, we'll have some moisture flying up and over the warm front, kind of overrunning it here. We'll also pull in some cool air from a cool source region as things are drawn in. We'll bring some cold air in to help keep the snow piling up across Montana while the showers are leaving Southern Cal for about a day. Here's how things start up. Showers around Long Beach and the Civic Center. Yeah, we'll see a little brighter conditions in some spots, but still could keep it wet San Diego for our day. Around to Sacramento, a few clouds holding on there as well. A little sunshine looks a little better for the afternoon, and not bad for Seattle and Portland, looking pretty good. Here's a current weather map showing the messes here, and the storm is still firing up tonight into central sections of Nebraska, northern Nebraska now, pretty stormy. Here's a look at the big picture, if you will. Still a few showers into portions of New York State. Here's how we started up tonight. I think there's a front in here somewhere. Yeah, sure is. Fairly mild air ahead of it. This thing is on the move to bring maybe some big storms toward Minneapolis, maybe Chicago. We could see a lot of wet weather, even for Phoenix, moving through our day. One of the bigger stories, though, will be the hefty snows, maybe piling up maybe a foot additionally into parts of Wyoming and into a bit of Montana, a few showers popping elsewhere. But again, it could be stormy in the afternoon around to Minneapolis. Here's a look at all the warmth, but I hate to do it, but the warmth is on the way out as that front makes its move. Up next on the Weather Channel, we're going to get travel-wise. Stay tuned.
An uncanny sense of hearing, but they can't tell you if running, climbing, or even walking hurts or makes them stiff. So it's up to you. To help keep your dog active and healthy, ask your veterinarian how Rimadyl has relieved arthritis pain for more than 500,000 dogs.
How did you get?
As with other pain relievers in this class, digestive and liver side effects may occur. Available by prescription only.
Fertilizer made for trees. One that feeds lives underground, at the root where trees eat. Job's fertilizer spikes. It's what trees want.
And a good Sunday morning. Thanks for tuning in to the Weather Channel. Will Annan along with Rick Griffin. You're going to be looking at just about everything today if you live in the Northern Plains and the Upper Midwest, from severe thunderstorms to big-time snows, especially near the Black Hills.
And farther west, much colder weather pattern coming up today with readings staying below freezing and a lot of the mountain locations of the west. Meanwhile, along the east coast, another very warm day is coming up. And we have some records for you that are just incredible from yesterday. How about Concord, New Hampshire? Well, 86. No, we didn't go back to last July and take this high temperature record map. This was yesterday, and that asterisk by Concord, New Hampshire means it was the warmest day ever recorded in the month of March, as the 86 in Milton, Massachusetts was, just outside of Boston. Boston's Logan, even right on the ocean, hit 85, so you know you had a southwest wind and no sea breeze, in other words. You can see all the other records: Worcester, Messina, up in the St. Lawrence Valley, Binghamton, New York, Portland, Maine, 75, Montpelier, Vermont, 72. What remains of the snowpack, by the way, is melting very quickly, and the rivers are running high in the Northeast because of the snowmelt conditions. These are readings compared to average yesterday. High temperatures 30 to 40 degrees above average. Maine, Massachusetts, all the way to the Niagara frontier into western Pennsylvania. In the south, above average as well. Very warm Saturday. While west of the Rockies, it was quite cold. There's a big winter storm out here with low snow levels down to 2,000 feet in California and 3,000 feet in Arizona. Some of the lowest snow levels of the cool weather season, as a matter of fact. Creed, Colorado's had about a foot of snow. Flagstaff, Arizona, about a foot of snowfall right now, and there's more snow to come. On the weather map, you can see low pressure now just east of the Continental Divide. It's west of the low in the front that the cold, moist air resides, with the rain in the valleys and the snow in the mountains, and strong gusty winds, so blowing and drifting snow is a problem too. Rain and storms right here, South Dakota, Minnesota. Some storms are severe out over the rural areas of South Dakota this morning. Meanwhile, from Texas to Virginia, northward, the weather is mainly dry, particularly mid-Atlantic, southeast, and southern plains. And with high pressure off the east coast, it's a Bermuda high, as we talk about in the warm weather months a lot. And on the backside of it, south winds in very mild conditions. We'll see how mild it is in just a moment. In the northeast, well, we have a few light showers over New Hampshire and Maine. There's a weak, very weak disturbance coming through, but you can see near Holton, Millinocket, Bar Harbor, some enhanced cloud cover and just a very little bit of precipitation. 37 in Caribou this morning, 45 in Bangor. Farther south, very mild, 57 in Boston and Rochester, 66 in New York City. The normal high temperature in New York's about 52 this time of the year, and it's 66 right now. It's 58 in Pittsburgh and 53 in Detroit. Look at the south, 60s Omaha, Oklahoma City. Houston's in the 70s, New Orleans and even 70, balmy night, warm night in Tampa. New Orleans, you're in the 50s, and Atlanta's just barely below 60 degrees right now. High pressure ridge, Carolinas through Florida. On the western edge of it, we've got isobars a little more packed together here, Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, and Louisiana. So we've got a brisk south wind, and there is moisture beginning to increase in the low levels. So we don't think there's going to be a lot of thunderstorm activity today here because, for one thing, the air is a little bit too warm in the upper levels. We call it a cap, and that may inhibit, let's say, significant thunderstorm activity. But farther north, near this warm stationary front combination, there's enough convergence and enough cooler air aloft so that severe thunderstorms are fairly likely here, particularly in Iowa, Minnesota, and Wisconsin. There's a moderate risk of severe storms, as a matter of fact, according to the Storm Prediction Center for today. We'll keep you up to date. Right now, near Chicago, south of Chicago, northwest Indiana, locally heavy rain. Rain showers, Eau Claire, La Crosse. Thunder showers, Rochester, Minnesota. And it's a bit wet this morning in Minneapolis, also near Duluth. And here are the isolated heavy thunderstorms over South Dakota. I think the warnings now have expired over the open areas northeast of Pierre. 36 in Rapid City, rain and snow mixed. Mid-60s, Kansas City and St. Louis. Much colder It's wintry in the west, no doubt about that. Strong storm moving on through. The radar picture right now to Salt Lake shows the snow. Idaho Falls areas had heavy snow overnight. Rain and snow here. Phoenix up into the White Mountains, snowing at the ski resorts, and rain showers in Southern California. A satellite picture shows a vigorous system in the west. Now to the forecast maps. Here's Will.
Okay, Rick, once again, we'll talk about winter storm warnings that are currently in effect all the way from Flagstaff, Arizona, get into the western Dakotas right through this afternoon. So the Black Hills could be looking at some appreciable amounts of snowfall. Big snows are likely there. Only light snow coming down right now or temporarily ending around Flagstaff, but you could be looking at yet another foot of snowfall by early morning tomorrow. That's our big storm system in the west. In the middle part of the country, you're going to be looking at some more scattered showers and thunderstorms. Rough day yesterday across parts of Illinois, Indiana, and Ohio. It could be the same situation again today. Extreme northern Illinois, Wisconsin, back in Iowa, and southeastern Minnesota, where some of these storms will become severe, and you could be looking at some heavy amounts of rainfall. And there is your heavy snow over the southwest. East Coast, again, is going to be mostly dry. Windy, about 80 degrees today for Boston, Massachusetts. Take a look at Philly and Washington, also hitting that 80-degree mark. If you live in the Midwest, watch out for the chance of severe weather, especially in southern Wisconsin, over towards Dubuque, Iowa, and Rochester, Minnesota, a little bit later on. Deep South, summer-like conditions here, sunshine, dry conditions, fire danger high in western parts of Texas and Oklahoma. And throughout the west, a real mess there. And it looks like, once again, if you live around Flagstaff, more snow is on the way.
Oh, but Seattle's going to be sunny today and in the 50s. Looks good. Stay tuned. TravelWise is next after your local forecast.
You've got it.
The all-new 1999 Mazda Miata. It's waiting.